I've been using this electric log splitter on a dolly and two milk crates to get it up a little bit higher, but it's still a little bit low and I'd like to build a better stand for it.
Ideally, the stand would be just a little bit narrower this way so I could stand closer to it and a tiny bit higher so I can pick up the pieces off of it without having to bend over at all.
I came up with an initial sketch of the design with a set of wheels on one end, and then I looked around and I found these wheels, which are just perfect for this, but not quite as wide as I was initially thinking. So I made the design a little bit narrower to accommodate the axle that I've got, and I'll try to make it out of some old scraps of 2x4. This drawing is 1 to 2.5 scale, so if I measure from here to here, 10 centimeters, that's actually 25 centimeters in real life. This part will cradle the feet of the motor on the log splitter, and then two legs go on here, like this. And then the axle goes here, and this will help hold the axle in place. And I want to put a piece of 2x6 through here. Well, I hope that wasn't too painful to watch. Now this part goes here. This will be the top of the other end of the stand, and the legs on that side will have to be a little bit longer, and I think I'll also make the stance a little bit wider. Now I gotta check that these come to the same height. So this makes a pocket that holds the feet in place. This part was kind of an afterthought. This notch hooks around the axle here. So when I put that in like this, I can lock the other end in place. Even if you buy split firewood, a lot of the pieces end up being split way too coarse, or not at all, like this one. And it's surprising how much a little electric log splitter like this can take. If you're splitting shorter pieces like this, it's annoying always having to wait for that cylinder to come forward. But this is why I made this thing in here. I put that there And then the cylinder can't go all the way back, so I don't have to wait as long. Now there's one more very important hint about using a log splitter like this. The cylinder pulls on these rods here, and the log pushes on here, which means there's a lot of leverage going this way, and there's a plastic pad that slides on here and on here. But these will slide a lot better if you just grease or oil this part here, and correspondingly on the bottom here. And it will run quieter, use less energy, and actually have more force that way.